Hey folks, welcome to TechMech, and in this episode we are going to discuss about operative words. Now, what are operative words? In a very simple sense, if we say that the words which operates the mood of the sentence are called operative words. For example, there's a sentence, I love you. It's a very plain one, three word sentence. Now, depending on the stress on the particular word, we can change the meaning of the sentence, the mood of the sentence, and eventually our acting will also change. For example, if we keep the maximum stress on the word I, what happens? I love you. You see, when I give the maximum importance on the word I point out towards me, and the meaning of the sentence is I love you, nobody else. Got it? Now, let's come to the second option, that is shifting of the stress from the word I to the word love. I love you. It means that I love you, I don't hate you. And you see how my acting changed? In the first I, when the importance was on I, it was towards me. And when now it is love, the importance was towards the love. And now let's shift the stress from the word love to the word you. I love you. It means that I love you. I don't love anybody else. So you see, depending on the stress of the word, for three different cases, my acting changed. More than acting, the meaning of the sentence changed. And hence, eventually, our acting also changed. So this is called the operative words. It is applicable anywhere, everywhere. And so what we say in animation is, what you say is important, of course, but how you say is also equally important, and that also equally stresses or expresses the mood of the sentence, and eventually our acting also changes depending on that. So what we will do now is we will take any one of these examples. We'll set a good camera angle, and we'll stress the importance on any one of these words. We'll act it out, and eventually we'll convert the acting into CG, that is computer graphics, with the expressions, the moods, the body language and everything, and we'll show how we act and how that acting gets converted to computer graphics. So guys, without wasting further time, let's jump into it and let's see how things roll. We will be stressing the maximum importance on the word love. My subject is sitting just beside the camera, and since we'll be stressing the maximum importance on the word love, it means that I love you, I don't hate you. So this is the approximate camera angle which we'll be setting it up. The subject is there, so let's start. It's a bit intense, of course. So this is the first pose, and slowly we'll be progressing. I love you! Open the package, man. Create cameras. The camera is there. Panels, perspective, camera one. And here we'll set the camera something parallel to, like, something what we have done here. So this is our camera angle. Love thing, I've already extracted the audio and kept it in WAV format. And so I'll just drag and drop it on the timeline. You can also import if you want. So if it comes directly, it is fine. Otherwise, just go here, right click the audio, and you see there's this, my audio is there, love. Click on this one and the audio is coming. Now there's one thing which you need to do here is just this box beside the word love. Go to the offset, audio, love. Go here and give a value, offset value of 1. This offset value of 1 means that Maya default will take anything from 0. Even the timeline was also 0, I made it to 1. So when I'm dragging and dropping the audio is also starting from frame number 0. So here I'm changing the audio to frame number 1 and henceforth onwards. And here we can see that the main audio is here. And let's take it as 70 to be a whole number. So this is what the setting of the audio, the setting of the camera. This was our acting.
I love you.
Okay. And for your convenience, try to download the S Pen. It helps in a lot of ways, just for markings and all these things. So this was our first pose. This is the second pose. Oh, in the first pose, I forgot to mention one thing. The body is not 100% straight, but a bit hunched forward. It goes back and holds, and then it comes to the last pose. And so these are the three poses which we need to mainly plot. And there is another one. From this red pose to the blue pose, there was a dip. Well, this is the approximate area where that dip happened. So this is how we can plot the keys. We can make an outline on the keys, though in the later stages you won't be needing this, but initially to start with, these will be of help to you. Once you click on the name of the package man on the channel box, there are many options, and one of them is GUI, graphic user interface. This was switched off till now. You can see a lot of other controllers which are there. Check it out for yourself. Just check the eye pupil here. So go to package man, click on the quick selection set, go to the last frame and key it. There are many places where we need to change the controllers again and again multiple times. So it's better that we store this default pose so that we can make use of it anytime. The first pose is not straight. Of course, if you see the torso is a bit hunched forward. Body is a bit hunched forward. So whenever the body is a bit hunched forward, when the body is bending forward, the pelvis should go back. And when the body is a bit hunched forward, it's always better that you take the pelvis a bit down. Let's see how does it look in the camera. Okay, so take it up a little. I feel the body should still be a bit hunched forward. You see, compared to these two poses. Okay, the hands are up near to the body. Now, if you see, my hands are almost in the same place, both the hands, which I will not do. I will take one hand a bit up and the other a bit down for the thing that I want to break the symmetry. Elbows are close to the body or maybe a bit outside. Let's see the camera. So here the fist is inside the body almost, but the elbows are out. So this is fine. The body can be a bit more hunched forward. The principle of exaggeration, as we know from one of those 12 principles of animation. And so this is approximately what the body looks like. So okay, so it is hold almost till like 15 frames. So we'll middle click, come here and just make it in 15. And now the body goes up. This is another pose. So where does it attain the pose? 22 or 23. So we'll go here, take the default pose up to 22. Otherwise, for all these things, we had to manually hold each and every controller and then give them the value of 0 and again, like it's time taking. So here, in this pose, the second pose, the body is a bit up compared to the first one. Torso is a bit bent forward. And when the bent forward, just take up the pelvis a little bit more. So guys, you see, when I'm taking out the pelvis, it is giving that IK jerk sort of thing. But I presume that this is absolutely fine in this case where you do not see the area below the pelvis, so you don't see the jerk. It's a cheating, of course, but yes, you are permitted to do it at times. Now we need to take the head down because the focus is missing. Later on we will adjust the eyes also. A bit bend on this side also. First it is here and then it is here. The fingers are not that clenched as it was earlier. We'll start rolling out the fingers a bit down and a bit up. So this is the second pose. Expression we will come later on. Okay, so this was the level of the first pose and this is the level of the second pose. I don't see much of a change. So what we can do is this three, right, the pelvis and the hands, take it down a bit, change accordingly the first pose. And then if you see, you can see a formidable amount of change. The first pose was somewhere here. Yeah, now we have enlarged the screen, so like this happened. The second pose, the level went somewhere here. That's okay. That's formidable amount of change. And now again, come here. Till how long does it stay in this pose? It stays somewhere till 35 approximately. We'll change the timing later on, but for the time being, make it till 35. Like there was a lot of floating in the last pose, but basically the pose happened somewhere at about 52. Yeah, we'll take it 52. As usual, we'll come here, take the default pose, go to 52, plot it out. It's easier, guys. When I bent the body forward, I should have moved the pelvis back, right? But no. You see, the pelvis also came forward. How is it possible? This is possible. Like this was this one, this was the one, move the pelvis. But now what happens? The body falls down, right? The body will fall down. So any one of these legs, make it forward. Yes. Even when I acted it out, my leg also moved forward, but that was not viewed in the camera because the camera angle was holding till my pelvis. So guys, even if you don't do this thing, nobody is going to point it out because people don't see what's happening outside the camera. But if you do it, there will be that feel good factor which always works out. Leg is forward and this is backward. You are rotating the pelvis, and what happens automatically to counterbalance? You rotate it back. One, it goes back, turns off. Check out the shoulders. Of course, when the hands are too much of forward and they're up, we will manipulate the shoulders. We will do it compared to what we have done it over here. This is called the exaggeration. This one here, any values? No values. This hand went up. So of course, we can take it up a little bit. These major three poses are done. Now, if you remember, there was one dip here, dip. This dip, we call it in between 35 to 52. An object takes less time to go down and more time to come up. So we will not create the in between in 44, but when the body will be going down in 42 and we will come up in 52. So we'll do the in between in 42.
I love you.
Now, as discussed, we will be making the in-between in 42, or rather the dip which we were talking about. This is the dip where the body goes from here to here down and then again it comes to a bit up. This is the dip part. What we can say that the height will be a bit less compared to the previous and the post one. As usual, we have plotted the key already here in 42. So here the body,
I love you.
And so we also see that the body is moving forward. So what we'll do here in 42, the key is plotted, we'll go here. So translation X, take it down. So you see guys, this is 35 and this is the last pose. and in between is a dip. So the dip will be going here, will be taking it down. The dip will be taking down. Now check the foot. The foot is not being seen, but it will make the difference. See, the foot is starting from 35 and ending it in 52. From 35 to 42 will settle the foot properly. It means that we'll copy the key of 52 and bring it in 42 for the foot. So here we'll take a dip of the body. All the dips will be more. And no matter what happens, dip happens or whatever, but my focus is always in front. Here we will focus perfectly towards our target who's sitting beside the camera. Guys, one thing which I can see here, that though technically we can see that the body is coming back, I mean the body is coming forward, but visually we don't see this change. So like that's of course one thing which we need to take care. So what we will do here is we'll bring them forward, more forward, so that it can be noticed. See guys, the leg needs to be more like this. Heel, take it up. Doesn't do much of change, but just to make it feel good from every angle, this key from 52, this 52 key will settle it here. It means that the leg will be settling early. This is the dip. Take it down, down, down. And guys, as you have seen, in case of the walk cycle also, the run cycle also, I had manipulated the values more than the actual. The main reason was to show the body dynamics. Now here also I'm doing more compared to what I did, but this is mainly for to follow the principle of exaggeration. Instead of learning it by heart, it's better that we go through these exercises and understand for ourselves. Okay, what about the hands? The hands here were close to the body, okay? And the hands were just going out. Take down the hands. Need to adjust the pole vector. You see, buddy, I'm not doing anything in the viewport, but I'm doing manually from this one. Graph. Translation Z. What happened? Okay, yeah. Take it forward. Bring it inside. Take it forward. Bring it inside. Take the pole vectors out. Take the pole vectors out. Just check at the rotation of the wrist. Can you see how much rotation it changed? Well, we'll go to the graph editor. Just click on this rotations. Go here, delete it. So now the rotation is basically opening up. Earlier there was no rotation almost. Well, from 35 to 42. And from 42 to 52, maybe 90% of the rotation happened. So here we have changed it. So we'll just take it down a bit. And if we want, we'll give a little bit of variation just to break the symmetry. Take it down a bit, take it up a bit. Change this rotation a little bit, just for a variation. In this pose also we had a variation. Here also we had a variation. You want to take it more up, and you won't take it more down, so that it can be clearly seen.
I love you. I love you. I love you.
Of course, we have added the in-between, which was not there in this version 1. Let's check the timing here.
I love you.
This was the hand position, okay? This was the last hand position, okay? And if you see here, it took a dip and went up. It took a dip and went up. I don't see much. Maybe it is there, but I don't feel that there's any dip or something like that. So here, both these hands will take a bit more down so that the change can be noticeable. Hand is there and it's going up and down. From here it is there. Again it came here. Again it went up here. This is what's happening. It's almost like a right angle. Ideally, if this would have been the starting point and this is the end point, I would rather take it little back, somewhere maybe not 100% in the in between middle, but somewhere here, so that there can be an arc almost. So guys, let's come here. We'll push it little back. So how things happen? We'll switch off this thing now. Do you see this
one?
Things are much better now.
I love you.
Let's see here.
You. I love you.
I feel this hit needs to be a bit more punchy, a bit faster, a bit snappier. This, especially this portion I love. I think we can speed it up a little bit. Yeah. I would request you to make multiple play blast or previews and check out for yourself. There are times where you might feel that the acting which you have done is a bit slow and you want to make it up a little faster, speed it up a bit more. You have every liberty to do it. So it's always better that you do in these places the previous time. Okay, so this is the old version.
I love you. I love you.
Here.
I love you.
There's a hit. It's definitely punchier.
I love you. I love you.
But one thing I feel that here could have started a couple of frames earlier. Because
love you.
I mean, I think by the time the action is starting, the love word, 80% of the love word is over. We will not change the timing.
Love you.
But we will change the time just a couple of frames back. You.
I love you.
Maybe a bit early. Couple of frames early.
I love you. I love you.
Fine, we are almost done with the timing part. Here we had to change the head. See, we can do two things. Either we can take up the head and focus, or we can take up the eyes a little bit. Hold this one. Click on any of the controllers. Go to this frame, press S. Go to this 15, press S. These are the keys for the step forward one key. So we'll just plotting the keys. Keys are being plotted. So it's easier for us to understand where we need to change. Here somehow, due to the manipulation of our head or something, the look at is almost the same. Here, as I have told, we have two options. Either we can take it up and focus it, or let the body get its own flow, but let's focus with the controller. We'll take the eyes up and we'll see that the eyes have changed. No, but still it is down. We'll go a little bit up. And you see, it's focusing. Here also it's focusing. Instead of the head being down, the eyes are focusing. Now we'll focus on the ease in, ease out, the offset of the hands and all these things. Now again, just check the shape of the hand. Take the pole vectors inside from all angles. Oh, this is still not done. Not looking good. This is okay. Looks much more decent.
I love you.
Now let's focus on the easy knees out and all these things. So here it is being held. In the initial stages, there was some moving hold. Okay, I'll show you how to do those. And then it went up and then it was doing it. So first leave it from 1 to 15, will come later. Let's focus from 15 to 22. From 15 to 22, the body goes up, and from 22 to till 33, the body continues to goes up, but that going up is very minor. It means that from 15 to 22, the body goes up. Okay. After 22, also the body goes up, but that's very, 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 very minor. So this is called the easy knees out part. This part, this particular part. So what the technique is, take the total controllers. 15 to 22, the body is going. 22 to 33, the body is on perfect hold. There's no change at all. What we will do, we'll click here and delete this key. So now the pause, which was continuing from 15 to 22, now it is continuing till 33. So as per the principle of the easing is out and the technical way of doing it, we will come somewhere here. You see, the amount of change which was happening from 22 to 32 was very minor. So we'll do one thing, we'll take this 27th key, middle click, and go to 22 and paste it over here. And let's see how it happens. This much of movement is fine. Of course, the wrist is making too much of movement. So from 15 to 22, the body is almost reaching 90% of the pose. From 22 to 33, the body is completing that 100%. That is the 10% the body is covering up here. Go to graph editor, go to frame number 33 and press on this flat tangent. So what happens, any undulations, any changes which might happen in course of time will be absolutely done with this option. Now let's check out the wrist. Guys, there are two things. One is the translation and another one is the rotation. We have to notice carefully which is that option which is making more. Notice from 22 to 33. I feel both the translation and the rotation needs to be adjusted, especially for the right hand. The left hand I'm okay with. So from 15 to 22, check out this thing. We'll just go up and adjust a bit. This one also, come down a little bit. We are just trying to bring this key closer to this key. The more you bring closer, the more you can reduce the movement which was happening. No change, no change. Z, come over here, bring this key closer to this key. This key, the more closer to bring this key, the less animation will be. See here, the difference is very minimum. So I don't feel that I should change anything. You see? Here, take it up a little bit. And now, yes, this is what we were looking for. Let's come to 46 to 70. Now 46 to 70, we can see that some movement was happening, especially the body moving forward. What we'll do here is, this is in between, cool, no issues, and then 33 to 40 and then 46 and then end. What we'll do is delete it. And we'll go somewhere about 55 or whatever, 58. And how much action do you want in the end? You want something like this? Then you copy the 55 key and paste it in 46 and adjust. You want something like this? It depends on how much action you want in the end. So I feel 60 is okay. Feel free to take your own key and manipulate accordingly. Go to 46 and paste it here. Go to the graph editor, flat tangent. I'm okay with the hands and everything, but I feel from 33 to 40 and 46, the pelvis has covered almost 99% of the translation Z. So now what I'll do, just for bring in the variation, and of course to match with this action I feel. So what is the movement of the pelvis in this action? This is the Z. Okay. So we will manipulate only the Z axis. How? Take it back a little. Okay. Now you see.
I love you.
So you see, the amount of translation Z which was not happening earlier is happening.
I love you. I love you.
I feel that the rotation of the right wrist is happening way too much in the end. So come here, go to the graph editor and check which option is having the maximum rotation. Maximum difference I can see not in X, not in Z, but in Y. This is the earlier one and this is the last one. See how much of difference is it? Whereas if you take consideration of this one, very less change. And of course, this is almost negligible, like very less. So I feel this is the rotation X, rotation Y, which is creating the maximum change. So what we'll do? Rotation Y, hold it. Move it closer to the end key. Yes, definitely it has reduced. Now, guys, there's another thing which I have missed out. That is the in-between from this pose to this pose. Carefully notice here.
I love...
When the body is going from here to here, there was a little bit of delay in my head which I have not given here. So what we will do? Now the body is going from 15 to 22. The 7 keys. We will divide this portion 3:4. 18. Make a key here. Delay a little bit in the head. Delay a little bit in the chest. When the body is going up, let this thing go down a little. So now you see, the same thing we will be implementing in the hands. How? The hands are going up. We'll take up the hands a little bit more up compared to what it was there in the in-between. We will keep the rotation downwards. How it was happening earlier and how it is happening now.
I love you.
I still feel that this right hand is a bit floating. I feel this is also the axis in which it's happening. We'll adjust this 3 and eventually see.
You.
Yeah, this is done.
I love you.
So you see, guys, how the body is getting up. Not a flat going up. No, it has a nice dip. The dip was not by the pelvis or something, but we utilized the dip, or we implemented the dip on some part of the body and let the pelvis flow in its own way. We did not disturb the pelvis at all. Now let's consider this 1 to 15. The pelvis moved a little bit to the side. If you carefully notice, this side to this side my pelvis moved. My hand, this hand, the fist was a little bit open in the early stages. A little bit, the fingers were open. Maybe it is very less noticeable. But then it clinched. It went tight. That happened for both the fingers of mine. So guys, these are the ways you need to figure it out, how to give a moving hold. When a character is just standing and not doing anything, but you want to keep the character alive, what would you do? You see, from here to here, the body was moving, right? We will not disturb the key number 15, we'll keep it as it is. In this one, we will shift it a little bit to the side. Did you see? Okay, this is one thing happened. Of course, when the body is moving, the hands cannot be like a sticky, something like that. Take down this hand a bit. Take up this hand a bit. Okay. Of course, the finger clinching. All values were 10. No, let's make it 2, 9. So you see, there's a very minor changes in the body I can see. And you can give a little bit something like this, just to keep it on a moving node, just that it should not be static enough. And if you feel that this movement is too much, how much movement you want? You want something like this? You want something like this to be in the initial stages? So go here, middle click on 10, go to 1, paste it. I think this looks much more logical, natural.
I love you.
So you see, our moving hold is being done. Now let's jump into the next step, that is the offset. Offset is what you can say that not going together. Yeah, that's the easiest definition of offset. It is being observed that all the body parts do not move together. So what does that mean? The hand and the body cannot go up together. I mean, not exactly at the same time. Of course, they'll go up. This is the place from where things starts to get a bit messed up. Messed up in the sense we will be dealing mostly with the shifting of the keys. Now see, from this 15 to 22, the body is going up. The hands are going up, pelvis, head, whatever. We will hold this hand, any one of these hands, actually logically it should be like either the hand should lead the body or the body should lead the hand. Hold these two hands and we'll start to make the hand go up a little before compared to the body. Here I can see that the hand goes a bit later compared to the going up of the body. Yeah. So what we will do here, hold the two keys, those three keys of both the hands, and shift it some one frame later. The body starts going up from here, but the hand does not. Again, what we will do, so that both the hands don't start getting up at the same time, we will select any one of the hands and then shift it one or two more keys. We can also shift it earlier also if you want. So what we will do is, we will start to make it go up from 13. But this is way too much. We'll go up at 14. We'll start taking to go up at 14. And this hand, you see, how's the change happening? This hand is going two frames early compared to the body. This hand is going one frame compared to the body later. And between these two hands, there is a change of three frames. This is starting from 14. This is starting from 16. Two frames. That's good enough. We will adjust this thing later on. Again, you see here, in 33, from this 33 to 46, both the hands start spreading outside. We'll see this one. Here the hand actually starts earlier than the body. Very minor observation, of course, but yes, this is how things work out. So hold the two controllers of the hand, select these three keys and shift it one frame earlier. You see, the hand starts getting one frame earlier to the body. Again, take any one of the hands, maybe this hand, and shift it one more frame or two more frames early. Maybe one from two more frame was too much. So we'll shift it one more frame back. So you see, guys, this hand settles one more frame later. This hand settles one more frame earlier. So there's an offset of two frames between these two hands. This is how, in a very easy way, we can do it. Now you see here, guys, if you see, this hand is going along with the body. So what we can do, just shift it one more key earlier. This hand, we can settle one more frame later, or maybe two more frames later. In that case, we can bring this thing very much in our control, that the body does not move together, all parts of the body does not move together. And this is how, in a very simple way, you do the offset.
I love you. I love you.
Now let's focus on a bit of details. My head went like that. And did you see my head? My head went in a very normal way. You see, my head is making some action in this rotation, in this axis. We will not create any extra keys. The more you create keys, the more it becomes difficult to adjust in the later stages. Carefully notice, I am not creating keys on the entire body. I am creating keys on those parts precisely where I need it. 33 to 40, somewhere in 36 we'll create a key. Somewhere we'll create a key, and what we will do is, what happened earlier? My head turned this side, this side. Little bit more, little bit like this. Now, here it will go this side, opposite actually. And still my head is wobbling. My focus is changing. We have to take care of that thing also.
I love you.
I think we can reduce it a bit. I think we have done way too much.
I love you.
we had made this action a bit snappier compared to our own action, so it's a bit faster. Let's check it out once again and see whether any other thing needs to be done before we jump into the expression.
I love you.
Yeah, there's one thing which I feel. The fingers are closed for too long. Like, and from here to here, all of a sudden, the 90% of the finger openings are happening. So what we will do, we'll go to 42 somewhere. We have selected both the hands, both the fingers of the hands. Either 42 or 43rd key for the finger opening will come and paste it in 40. So in that way, the fingers will not remain closed for so long and it will open a bit early. Another thing, the pole vector, if you guys notice here, fine, all of a sudden, this elbow is coming inside. 33 to 40, the elbow was always lying outside the pole vector. All of a sudden, from 40 to 45, did you see the change? Let's see here. It'll be more. See guys, did you see the pole vector? So what we will do here, we'll come here, delete this pole vector and see what's happening. Maya has taken its own position. Now let's see. Much better. That's it for the blocking and the pre-secondary, because secondary also includes the expression and lip sync and everything. So in the next chapter, we will take care of the secondary animation, and at the same time, we will do some polishing and make it presentable.